Israel's Iron Dome defense system isn't really iron, nor is it a dome, but it does act as a shield over the country, guarding it from incoming air attacks. Here's how each piece of the elaborate system works. Ever since modern Israel was founded in 1948, it's contended with one conflict after another, including unending civil strife and conflict with the Palestinians, who had previously inhabited the territory that became the new Jewish homeland. Israel became embroiled in wars with Arabs from surrounding territories in 1948, 1956, 1967, 1973, 1982, and 2006, pitting nearby countries against the staunch ally of the United States. Throughout that time, Islamic militant terrorist group Hamas struck out at Israel again and again. In 2007, Hamas took over the entirety of Gaza, a Palestinian territory along the Mediterranean Sea. Countries including Iran fund Hamas and supply it with advanced rocketry that then rains down on Israel. If Israel is at daily risk of rocket fire from the sky, why isn't every single patch of ground in Israel blasted apart by rockets, mortar shells, drones, and other forms of weaponry? The answer is some considerably advanced ground-to-air defense technology. In general, a surface-to-air missile, or SAM, is the most common way to take down a missile en route to a target. This is essentially one's only recourse for defending from such airborne attacks as of now. Israel's so-called Iron Dome is a defense network of 10 batteries of SAM launchers placed strategically around the country. The Iron Dome shields citizens from destruction, is extremely effective, and has saved untold numbers of Israeli lives. The dome is a range, and the system intercepts whatever seeks to infiltrate the region from the air. Outlining how the whole system works, CNN says that each of the dome's 10 missile batteries houses 3 to 4 missile launchers. Batteries detect incoming projectiles, missiles, mortar shells, drones, and so on, of a distance ranging between 2.5 to 43 miles. They relay information about the projectile's likely target to a command center. If the projectile is headed for an area with no people, it's allowed to pass through the dome. If not, the dome shoots a missile to intercept the incoming attack. If there are multiple incoming projectiles, the system determines an order of relevance and intercepts whichever ones will do the most damage to people and property first.
But still, there's too many rockets raining down here. Today only, we had over 50 rockets already which hit.
One of the most versatile features of the Iron Dome is its maneuverability and ease of arrangement. Each missile battery is mobile and can be transported to where it's needed most. When set into place, the whole thing can be activated and ready in a matter of a few hours. The dome's Tamir missiles themselves, CNN explains, are long and surprisingly thin, 10 feet long but only 6 inches in diameter. They're also fairly light, less than 200 pounds per missile, and very agile. About 24 pounds of each missile's weight is explosives. As mentioned, Israel's Iron Dome has proven essential to its defense, and yet the system wasn't online until 2011. According to CNN, work on the Iron Dome began in 2007, tests commenced in 2008 and 2009, and the system was activated in 2011. The BBC notes that the Dome, considered the world's most advanced surface-to-air defense system of its type, was developed by Rafael Advanced Defense Systems and Israel Aerospace Industries in tandem with the United States. The timing of its development, the year that Hamas took Gaza, was not coincidental, and the system was designed to suit the type of armaments employed by Hamas terrorists in Gaza. To illustrate how critical the Iron Dome is to Israel's safety, the BBC says that in Hamas's early October 2023 attacks, the system shot down about 90% of the 3,000-plus individual rockets that were fired in a single week.
Iron Dome has shot down thousands of these things over the years.
Elsewhere, the Israeli Defense Forces website says that in May 2023, the Iron Dome intercepted 95.6% of all missiles it intended to take down. As it stands, the only way to counter the Iron Dome would be to overwhelm it with numbers. Public confidence in the system is so high that young people in Israel have even taken to spectating Iron Dome defense launches. The Iron Dome has been so successful that the Jewish Virtual Library says Israel has started selling the technology to other countries. Azerbaijan bought an Iron Dome in 2016, and India and Romania await the acquisition of systems of their own.